Summary of The Gifts of Imperfection. Let go of who you think you're supposed to be and embrace who you are. By Brené Brown. Key takeaways, summary, and analysis included. Written by William Beckett. Narrated by Natalia Sanchez.
Preface. The Gifts of Imperfection, Let Go of Who You Think You're Supposed to Be and Embrace Who You Are, is a prominent self-help book by Brené Brown that has sold over 2 million copies and has been translated into 30 languages. This New York Times best-selling book uses anecdotes and research to create a coherent, enjoyable reading experience. Throughout the book, Brown teaches how we should learn wholehearted living so we can fully embrace the different opportunities and joys life provides us. An expert on shame, Brown brings her professional expertise to her book to show readers how to cultivate self-worth and let go of the perfectionistic tendencies that make it hard for people to feel fulfilled in life. Brown came upon her conclusions after she experienced burnout professionally and sought therapy to fix her broken relationship with success and worth. She shares professional and personal wisdom that helps readers reorient their relationships with themselves. Brown expertly leads readers using 10 guideposts that target different emotional entities to improve our lives within our bodies, minds, and souls. Ultimately, Brown encourages readers to leave behind the people we feel pressured to be, and to be instead the versions of ourselves who make us the happiest. This audiobook encapsulates key takeaways found in the original book. We've also provided an in-depth analysis as well as removing any fluff to save you hours of your time. If you've read the original, then this audio summary will help you solidify the most important lessons. Foreword. In her book, The Gifts of Imperfection, Brené Brown begins by describing how her career was built around pattern seeing. She explains that once a person finds a pattern, it is hard to stop seeing that pattern, which impacts how people behave. The human mind is wired to see these patterns, and accordingly, we automatically look for them to create meaning out of stimuli. Brown is a researcher and professor who enjoys finding patterns in her work and building meaning around them, but she was caught off guard with her research in November of 2006 when she almost wished to unsee the research because of how unexpected it was. She created a study to examine shame in people. As she looked at the stories of the participants, she used the word wholehearted to describe how much they embraced life. Wholehearted people lived to the fullest and weren't afraid of being vulnerable. Brown searched these people for what they had in common. With her results, she compiled a list of things to do and not to do to be wholehearted. The part of the study that shocked Brown was that she discovered that the wholehearted people were not behaving in the same way she was. In fact, she was doing many of the opposite things to the wholehearted people. She realized how critical it was for people to embrace themselves and live unashamed, and she was not living a life free of the pressures of perfectionism. Brown didn't confront her results until 2008, when she began working with a therapist, because her life felt like it was falling apart. She felt burnt out from her career and wasn't sure what to do about it, but gradually, she worked through her issues and began to reignite her creativity and joy. She was reintroduced to the happy parts of her life and stopped thinking so much about concerns such as what other people thought of her or perfection. Her spiritual awakening led Brown to write a book on her newfound knowledge. She says, "I now see how owning our story and loving ourselves through the process is the bravest thing that we will ever do." That is the heart of her message as she continues to explain the steps to a wholehearted life throughout the book, leading us on a journey to being at peace with ourselves. Introduction. Wholehearted living. The journey. To live wholeheartedly, people must remember that wholehearted living is a journey, not a destination. Brown urges readers to contemplate what things we need to bring on our lifetime journey. She suggests that we need courage, compassion, and connection, which seem like difficult things to obtain, but practicing these three things each day can be invaluable because they make us vulnerable. As humans, vulnerability gives us a great opportunity. The wholehearted journey is not an easy one, and we will face many obstacles as we go on it, However, throughout her book, Brown gives readers the tools they need to overcome the hardships of wholehearted living. She helps readers find love, belonging, and authenticity in their lives, which are the heart of wholehearted living. Defining moments. Many of the terms Brown uses.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.